Hello everyone, welcome to Lara Tips. In today's video, we'll be looking at 6 new things that were added to Laravel version 9.7.0. The first thing that has been added was the delay support for batch jobs. In the version earlier than 9.7.0, the delay wouldn't work for the batch jobs. Let me show you that. So let me show you here, the current PHP artisan version is 9.6.0. In this version, whenever we used delay in the job batches, then it wouldn't work. So here I have this testing job over here and I have added delay, and each delay has 1 second more delay than that of the other. Now if I just come here and show you that testing job, it is just logging to the database. And let me show you here this Laravel log over here now. Okay, now here I'll run this code. It has run the batched job, and you can see here everything ran at the same time, 15, 15 and 15, which means that it is not considering the delays. Now let me upgrade to Laravel version 9.7.0. It is now upgraded to Laravel version 9.7.0. Let me stop this server and again run this PHP artisan coalition. And now let me change this to 2, 4, and 6 over here. And again, I'll run it and let me go here. And you can see here, it is not running at the same time. The next thing that has been added is this where not null method on the model resources. So let me show you that I have this user resource over here like this, 2 array. It has ID, name before. I'm writing here name before just to show that it is for the earlier version of Laravel. And if I just go to web.php, you can see here this user test. And whenever I visit this user dash test, I am here only selecting ID and name and then returning the new user resource. So let me visit that URL over here. So if I just reload over here, then we can see both ID and name. But if I don't select name over here, then it will show only ID. But for this to happen, I had to go to this user resource and write this when this name is not equal to null and this name like this. I had to always check like this. But now there is a new method, when not null. We don't have to just check this each and every time. Just write this when not null. Doing this and doing this is the same thing. If I just go here and reload, then you can see here I'm not saying the name field. And again, if I come here and just undo the changes and again come here and refresh, then I'll see the name field over here. The third thing that has been added is this where belongs to, accepting the collection instead of only single model. Before, if you had to use where belongs to for the multiple models, or let's say multiple users or categories any model, then you had to do it like this, or you could just simply use wherein. But instead of exposing the database column to this query, there was this method added previously so that whatever be the column name of the database, it would automatically work. We don't have to worry about the name of the database column. So when we use this one, then we had to do it like this. But now instead of using like this, you could directly use this where belongs to and pass a collection, models collection. Let me show you that over here. So here I'm just looking in the logins table, and those logins that belongs to user, I'm getting those. Then you can see here, I am getting all the logins of that user with the ID of 1. But if I just do this user 1 and 2, whenever we use an array inside the find, then it will return a collection. So if I just write here users and hit reload, then you can see here, I am getting all the logins of the users with the ID of 1 and 2 both. The fourth thing that has been added is this where in route parameter constraint method. Let me go to web.php over here. And I have this task/task type route. And if I pass here wherein like this, then we can only pass revision or test in the task type over here in the URL. And if you pass any other thing than these two values, then it will throw 404 not found. Let me show you that over here. Here, if I just reload over here again, then you can see here this revision. Okay, I'm just returning whatever it is passed here. Just it is returning just that thing. So here revision, but if I try to pass revisions and hit enter, then you can see here 404 not found. The fifth thing that has been added is this string squeeze helper method. Let me show you that as well. So I'll just comment this out and here. So what that squeeze method does is it just squeezes all the white spaces inside a string. Let me show you some of the examples over here. All these examples are from that pull request. You can see here there are a lot of spaces in between, in front and in the end of a string. But if I just run it, then you can see here it is removing all the unwanted spaces and just adding one spaces in between the words. It will be very handy if you are trying to concatenate some of the strings, and let's say some of the string already has a space in it and you are also adding space when you are concatenating. So in that case it is very, very useful. So not only for the space, it also works for this tab and new lines like this. You can see here whenever I reload, then it is showing me the same thing. And again, if I uncomment it, and even if you have this thing like this, then also it will just show the same thing. It will remove all the unwanted empty characters. Finally, the sixth and the last thing that has been added is this where JSON contains keys query builder method. So here in the users table, I have just added this random meta column just to test it out. I have added here languages, and here EN and NP. There are two languages, and here it has only one language and all of the others do not have any languages. Now let's say if we only want the users that have this languages key inside the meta column, then now we can do that using just query builder method. So here, let me just comment this out, and we can do it like this. So where JSON contains key, like this, we have this new method, query builder method, that has been added. And if I run it, then I'll only get these two users, because only these two users have this languages key inside this meta column. Not only this, but also we can use array indexes over there. So let me show you here like this. If I write here 0 like this, so let me not write 0, let me write 1. So if the JSON contains key 1, which means that the second value, so here this one, if there is at least 2 items inside the language, then only it will show, otherwise it will not show. In this case, it will only show the user with the ID of 1. If I just reload over here, then I'll just get user with the ID of 1. But if I just write over here 0, then it will get both of those users, because both of them has at least 1 item in the languages array.